Now that we have a complete long series and two long videos, so one is 3 hours and a half and one is 1 hour, now we can start to have some fun. Now we can start to build projects, because this is what I will focus on in 2026. So many of you asked me, okay, Rust is cool, I understand ownership, I understand everything, but now, Francesco, we want to get our hands dirty. So how can we get our hands dirty? By building projects. So we will build projects together. In the second part of the Rust Bootcamp, we will build one, at least one project, but it can also be multiple projects together. So this is a great opportunity. Of course, you need to watch the free Rust Bootcamp part one before season two, I will say, the second part. I will dive deep into Rust frameworks, especially web frameworks, especially for backend, but it can also be something for the frontend. And of course, we will use libraries. So before Christmas, I should release an Axum video. Axum is a web framework in Rust, and I will, of course, mention libraries, many, many libraries. Now I don't work as a developer advocate anymore, so I can full focus on the YouTube channel, Rust videos, Rust live event, Rust posts, Rust conferences, a lot of Rust lately. And of course AI, of course AI. This will be on the 16th of January, and we have, this time we have 2 hours. Some people told me that this was a bit too late, especially for the Indian audience. I put this 1 hour earlier. This is the best I can do. And the goal is that by the end of this bootcamp, we will build something together. I might even go a bit slower. About conferences, in January, I will go to Laracon India. Then in February, I will go to Rust Nation in London. In London, I'm super excited because I want to bring a very spicy topic, which is, this is the title, hold on, Rust is not hard to learn. So I'll try to debunk this myth and stereotype. I don't know if I can do it. I will try. Then in March, I have a conference here in Rome. Cool. And then I have another 2 more conferences in the US already confirmed. Maybe 3 conferences in the US. Mind blowing. We will see. Maybe 4. No, I think 4 is too much, but I think at least 3. The Rust book should be out before the end of 2025. I still didn't announce it yet on social media, because, you know, once you announce something on social media, it has to happen, especially if you have a big audience. But it should be out, I think at 95%, it should be out before 2025 ends. Maybe even before Christmas, maybe. But if there are some technical issues, but the book is basically done. I started making this in April 2024. It has been a while. I think I have a problem. One of my problems is that I create too many videos. You see this? This is what is Rust. You see this playlist here? This is a playlist of 54 videos, and most of them are, let's say, 15 minutes. I think we are way over 15 hours. I know. I know. Sometimes it's hard even for me. I'm sorry, I created too many videos. A shorter version of Bootcamp, a longer Bootcamp version with Rust by example, with 3 hours and a half. And then, you know, once you are in the Rust rabbit hole, I have a whole free playlist. I also want to talk about the new live events. So my goal, it will be to have at least 1 live event per week. Well, at least 1 live event per week, and it can be about a specific topic or building stuff. I think that now we can focus more on building stuff. Another option, it might be to try Rust Links. Do you know what Rust Links is? Basically a series of exercises to learn Rust. I can just do them live, for example. So I can try some Rust stuff here. or we can do a full refresh since the beginning of Rust. I want to make more events about Docker, because Docker, I think, evolved a lot in the past few years. So I want to talk about, especially Docker with AI. I think Docker is doing great things. For example, you can run models directly using Docker. I want to start finally in 2026 to create more content about AI, but of course not AI videos, not AI generated videos. Like, I am curious about using AI as a developer. This is what I'm curious about. Like, you are a developer, how can you use AI to improve your workflow, to improve your productivity? So you want to start with Rust and then Deoxys and then Solana. I made a video with Rust and Solana, you might be interested. So I highly recommend to check Rust Bootcamp Part 1. Then, depending on how much time you want to invest, I have an extended version of the Rust Bootcamp, which is more like Rust by example, 3.5 hours, or you can go on single topics. Do you want me to create a Rust roadmap? I think there is not enough material for Rust and web development, especially backend. It can also be some front-end. One thing it might be to have, for example, Axum on the back-end, I don't know, TanStack on the front-end. I'm working on something. Let's create an AI framework with Rust. This is interesting. I think there is a project in Rust that lets you use LLMs, but I need to find it. I think that the best rig, exactly. Bravo. Bravo Emojo. Exactly. Do you want me to explore Rig? I think I will meet the creator of Rig at Rust Nation in London. If you have any ideas, you should always type them down. Because I'm here thinking about new topics for new videos and new live events. I want to put Rig on the possible things that we can do, even next Saturday. What do you think? You know what will be very cool? A long live stream about the Rig. This is one of the things I want to try. Yes. I really like the logo. And what is Rig? Who is using Rig? Simple example. This is actually cool. The only problem, I think, is that it requires an OpenAI API key. I will try. I really want to try it out. It might be interesting. I don't know, will we survive in this AI era or not? We will try. We will not give up easily. We will keep fighting in this AI era against Terminators. I hope you're not giving up. Are you letting AI to replace you? I hope not. AI won't replace me. AI can't replace you if you don't have a job. My life is amazing. I feel like that I'm taking back my time, which is very important, because basically I never stopped. Even when I quit my job in 2021, I wanted to do exactly this, and then I got basically not distracted, but let's say I found this opportunity in working in developer relations. But this is exactly what I wanted to do. So, creating videos for you, finding something that can be useful, building some projects. I didn't even plan the public speaking one, by the way. This is exactly the style I would like to do. Before I was very anxious, now I feel more confident into sharing my life, sharing what I do. I could have never do a video like this, I don't know, like 3 years ago. Like me just turning on the camera, talking about my life, turn it off, and then also editing. I think we all have something that we want to talk about, and this is why I like YouTube so much. I like YouTube because it's like your own small TV. You can just share whatever you want, share whatever you like. You can do shorts, you can do live events, you can record stuff, you can hide your face. And this is something that makes content creation so beautiful for me. And this is also why starting making videos basically changed my life. It really changed my life, and I'm happy to be here on my channel to talk about what I want. I can decide if I want to build a project, if I want to talk about me. Usually it will always be a mix. I want to go back on doing live events on Saturday. Most of you are interested into this. I think the best solution would be to have a mix. So having a mix of fixed topic we want to talk about. It can be about some news, it can be, you know, some Cloudflare down or something important happening in tech. Do you like this idea? I would really like you to know. You know, sometimes for me it's a bit hard, still hard to do these live events because, you know, I need your feedback, your text, you letting me know that you are here. So that would really mean a lot because then I know that what we are doing here is meaningful, it can really help someone. But for example, for the Rust Bootcamp, I got very, very good feedbacks. So this really makes me very, very happy. When I quit my job in 2021, I really wanted to do this. But then I got into developer relations, but that was not planned. But I'm happy. But now I really want to let you know that Francesco is back full-time here on YouTube with you. We can decide together. I would really like you to always give feedback because lately I've been sharing a lot of... I have many questions, so I'm not sure exactly what I want to do. I know the main topics, which is basically Rust, DevOps, Docker, and AI, but AI not just, you know, random stuff. I want to pick something having the approach from an educational point of view, share something useful. It can also be something new, because usually, you know, the hot topics, there's always interesting. I really read all the comments. So if you have any question or any feedback, this is probably the best moment to do it. Thanks everyone for joining. I really enjoyed this live event. It has been a while. And this is my first, I think, live event since I announced that I quit developer relations for now, of course. I want to code. I want to get my hands dirty, code more. I made a video, of course. If you didn't check, it's one of the latest videos on the channel. That's it. Wrap up. Bye. Ciao.